Hi, I'm Vani Bakshi, team captain of team number 31, and the topic for our capstone project is lifetime enhancement of wireless sensor networks.
Hello, my name is Parul.
Hello, my name is Chirag Gupta.
Hi, my name is Arman Mittal.
So our components used in our project are solar panel, followed by battery. This is a switching circuit. These are the three sensors which are used here. This is the buck converter, and this is a switch. This is the Arduino Uno, and for measuring the sensor, we have used the LCD display to display our outcome.
Now, I will be explaining the working of the entire project. Initially, we will see how the sensors sense all of the information and present it on the LCD display via powered from the battery. So the main aim of our project is to enable the switching circuit wherein during the night time the entire project will work only on the batteries when the solar energy is not available, and during the daytime when solar energy is available, then the whole experiment will work on the solar energy and the switching will take place. So basically here, as I switch on, we can see all of our sensors, our buck converter and our Arduino Nano are working. Here we can specifically see that solar is not connected to the entire circuit and the entire circuit is working. This is the DHT11 sensor which senses temperature and humidity. Here we have an MQ2 and MQ3 sensors which measures alcohol and pressure respectively. These three sensors require only 5 volt of power, and therefore we have used the buck converter. We have used a 13 volt solar panel only because the three lithium cells that we have used are of 3.7 volt each, which combine to form an equivalent of approximately 12 volt, and therefore to be able to charge this cells while the experiment is not using the cells and the experiment is working on solar energy, we have used a 13 volt solar cell so that it has enough power to be able to run the whole experiment simultaneously, and as well as that charge the three cells that have been used during the night. So how the circuit works is, we can see that this entire experiment right now is working along with the lithium cells that we have attached. Now I will connect the entire experiment with the solar energy, and this LED will glow, which will show us that the entire circuit is now working on solar energy. Here, since the LED is glowing now, we can see that the entire setup is now working on solar energy. We have the switching circuit here. Here we have a relay and the entire connections. All of the block diagram is attached in the report that will be presented later. And the entire circuit is now working on solar energy. Now, as you can see, that our entire project is working on solar energy. And simultaneously, since this LED is glowing, which represents that the entire project is working through the solar energy, and simultaneously all the batteries that were drained last night or when solar was not available, these batteries are being charged simultaneously by the solar energy that is being provided by the panel, which is indicated by this glowing LED. Now, the values of the sensors, which is temperature, humidity, alcohol and pressure, are being measured on the LCD, and this is our entire experiment, and this is how we have enhanced the lifetime of a wireless sensor network.